try to keep you close to me, but life got in between. Tried to square, not be in there, but said that I should have been. Hold back the river, let me look in your eyes. Hold back the river so I can stop for a minute and see where you hide. Hold back the river, hold back.
Particularly in our state, we're the largest animal welfare agency in the state. We serve 5,300 to 5,500 animals a year. And I think that we are just the little shelter that could. We have come so far. Our save rate has increased tremendously in just the past 2 years. The progress is just monumental. We went from a staff of 9 people, today we have 39. We offer play groups for the dogs 7 days a week. Play groups, of course, offer some exercise and release, but they also help dogs cope with shelter stress better. Our save rate in cats has increased from 8%, single digits, 8% to 86% last year. And so we have just, what makes us different, I think, is the staff. We have the best staff in the world. The people don't work here for the money, they work here for the cause. I have several employees who have taken significant pay cuts just to come work somewhere that they feel that the work is rewarding.
I think when you think of an animal shelter, you think of a dark, hopeless place where animals come to die. The Kanawha Charleston Humane Association is not that. When we come up here, everybody's smiling, everybody's happy, everybody gets along. We're a family. I've only been here since November, and I already feel like I'm part of a family here. So it's pretty incredible to be a part of something like that. And you know, not only that, these people have a passion for animals that I've never seen. And to see that every day is pretty amazing. They work way beyond 9 to 5. Our behaviorists, I didn't even know they were animal behaviorists, and I'm still learning things every single day. But the love that these people have for animals is amazing.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home.
Settle down. I think the entire staff just dreams of a modern, safe facility, one that promotes animal health and mimics our dedication to the animals. Our facility was built in 1996, which is not old, we understand, is not old, but it is very heavily utilized. We have doors falling off the hinges. We had a horrible rodent problem before I took this position. If you kick the door facings in the kennels, mouse poop falls out. It's absolutely disgusting. Everything is broken. The parking lot, of course, is settling. And there's just the shelter, to see our physical plant, as I call it, you could never understand how much the staff care. We would just love to have a facility that serves our animals as well as our staff does.
You know, moving forward, obviously, we have to make our operating costs first. It costs us $600,000 more to operate now than it did in 2012. Our euthanasia rate back in 2012 dwindled as low as 29 to 31%. We're euthanizing almost 70% of animals that came through our doors. That breaks my heart, and it breaks a lot of people's hearts in this building. And that's why the changes were so necessary. We saw 5,000 animals last year, and we were able to save 90% of them. And that's something that I think everybody here is very proud of. But We desperately need help. We have goals for the shelter that go beyond our operating costs, but right now it is extremely important that we at least meet that goal. Our budget last year was $1.6 million. These are just random stats, but in 2012 on the books, our medical care was right around $300. Last year was $40,000. Animals weren't being treated back then. We were not treating hit by cars. We were euthanizing hit by cars. So it's an awful thing to think about. We're not going back to where we were. We're just moving forward. And that is going to take a lot of help. We need help badly.